God. I hope you two will be fine. Pray for one another. Appreciate the Lord. He's keeping us alive and healthy. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Pray for one another. Always praise. The more you praise, the more you'll be blessed. Thank you. and Pearly Shadow. I hope you like it. Up can turn belief, he can turn all the truths into medicine. And if you have a disease, if you become sick, if possible, don't go to the hospital. Just believe in those words, because he is alive. Jesus, who have spoken those words 2,000 years ago, is just right beside us, but invisible. 2,000 years ago, he was visible. Now he is invisible. I believe he is right beside you, whispering in your ear those words. Believe in those words. Trust in those words. If you don't trust, you can go to the hospital and you can let the surgeon, physician, let them heal you with the help of the machine, sophisticated machine, high-tech machine. God has given the inventors, researchers, brain. God has given the power, talents. Brain to invent those machine, high-tech machine, the machines that can diagnose the disease, the machine, amazing machine that can cure the disease, heal the disease, and powerful medication, medicine, powerful medicines. God has given them to invent those machines, to create those machines. But some researchers, inventors, doctors, they forget God. They forgot God, who create those machines. But some inventors, researchers, they give thanks to him, what he has done for them. And I appreciate, and I am proud of those high-tech machines, those amazing machines. I give thanks to them, to the person who invented them, those machines, to the researchers who invent, who create those powerful medications. Some people, some researchers, inventors, they appreciate the Lord who gave this brain power, intelligence, ability to invent those things, those machines. But some people, some inventors, they forget God. But God, never mind, God loves them, God forgives them. And if you don't trust in those words, as I said before, you can go to the hospital and let the surgeon, physician, let them heal you, cure you with those amazing machines, with the help of the amazing machine. Yes, your disease, sickness can be cured, but the doctors, the surgeon cannot guarantee you that those disease has gone for good. They cannot guarantee it can reappear. But if you let God heal you, God can guarantee you that those diseases cannot come back. guaranteed. That's why if you trust in those words, if you trust Him, He is alive. He's the living God. Your sickness, disease can be cured. It can never return. It can never reappear. Believe. If you don't trust, never mind. God forgives you. God loves you. You can go back. You can go to the hospital and let the physician, surgeon heal you. So, as for me, I trust in those words. That's why, to be honest, up to this age, I didn't take a medicine. Instead of taking medicines, I pray from the bottom of my heart and I believe in those words. I pray before I eat. Have meals, even snacks, even water, God can turn into medicines. Believe, because He is alive. Jesus Christ, the words that He had spoken 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ is existing now. 2,000 years ago, He exists. But He is visible. Now He is also exist, but invisible. But just believe. Those words are, He is reminding you, those words, believe. If you don't believe, never mind. He forgives you. You can go to the hospital. And I'm testifying. Because he's the one and only God who have promises upon His children. And if you have a chance, opportunity, testify. Mention His name on YouTube, from internet. Boldly, be bold, don't be shy. Be bold, boldly mention His name, confess, testify on the YouTube internet that He is the living God, God of gods, Lord of lords. Testifying because He is alive, otherwise I won't testify. Don't be shy. Mention, I use. Don't miss this chance. Testify on from YouTube. Before you present your talent, whatever talent on YouTube, before presenting, before giving thanks, thank Him. Appreciate Him first. And boldly, be bold to mention His name. Don't feel shy, don't feel awkward, because He is alive. Because of Him we are alive, we are living, we are breathing. And another thing is, we are living, we are healthy, because we are young, taking medication regularly, going to the doctor's clinic and check regularly, and taking medication, and because we are young and because we are taking physical exercise, that's why we are healthy, we are alive. No, that is not true. Because of Him, we are alive. Our life depends on Him. We don't own ourselves. He owns us. In a few minutes, I might get collapsed. dead, I might be collapsed and dead from die from heart failure, cardiac arrest, I don't know. He's already known. My life is in his hand. And tomorrow, I don't know, I might get killed from car accident. I don't know, but he already know. So ask him, all is in his hand. Ask him to protect from those dangers, accidents, from those disease, to get rid of those diseases. Ask, pray, will answer your prayer. He will protect you from those dangers. He will let you alive, keep you alive, keep you living. But ask him to keep you alive, to keep on living, but not for enjoying, boasting, bragging the luxurious life, but for doing his job, spreading the gospel. Ask him, let him use, let him keep you alive. He will keep you living. Keep on. He will keep you alive. Because I'm testifying boldly, because he is alive. Otherwise, I wouldn't testify. Believe in those words. 2,000 years ago he had spoken those words. Your faith has made you healed. That's what belief is, just right beside you. As for me, those words are echoing in my ear, in my mind always. That's why I didn't take any medication. To be honest, honestly, up to this age, believe because he is alive. He's the only one in God who have promises upon his children. He never breaks his promises. Let the other people mention his name, introduce him to the people who don't know him yet. Introduce him, let them know about him, but not to become Christian, but to become a born-again person, to let them know the genuine Lord, God of gods, Lord of lords. For one another, forgive one another. God has already forgiven you. God sees, looks on the bright side of you. He didn't see on you the bad side of you. He looks, he sees on the brighter side of you and forgives you. That's why forgives and look on the brighter side of the people who are against you, who hate you. Even God forgives you, forgives them. And boldly, be bold to mention his name. Don't feel shy, don't feel bad, don't feel awkward to mention his name on the YouTube, anywhere. Because he is alive. Otherwise I won't testify. Thank you for listening. Pray for one another. Keep praying. And pray for me too. I'm still a sinner. My English is not good, but I hope Holy Spirit will translate on behalf of me for the people to understand. I believe my English is not good enough, but I believe Holy Spirit will translate on behalf of me to the other person to understand. I believe. And those words are not my words, words from the Holy Spirit. The words that I have spoken are not my words, words from the Holy Spirit. Let him use. With him, you'll be something. Without him, we are nothing. And I'm going to continue with a medley of amusing songs, yummy songs, and jambalaya, forgive me, I forgot the name of the song, but I hope you like it. Good for listening. Thank you. songs. And medley of Yoroyang and Burmese songs, cover song medley of Yoroyang and Nangit. I'm going to play. I'll try my best. you for listening. God bless you all. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Pray for one another. Appreciate Him. He's keeping us alive, healthy, and believe in those words 2,000 years ago. He said to the sick person, the person with disease, your faith has made you heal, made you whole. Those words. Believe in those words. Trust in those words. Jesus Christ, who has spoken those words, are right beside you, existing, but invisible. Believe in those words. And if you believe, you don't need to go to the hospital. Believe, because He is alive. That's why, to be honest, I didn't take any medication up to this age. Instead of taking medication, I pray from the bottom of my heart before I eat meals, food, even snacks, even water. It can turn it into medication, medicine. Believe. You don't need to take any medication. Believe. All these things He creates are for the best for His children. He creates the best for His children. Even a little bit of alcohol, a little bit of cocaine, He can turn it into medicine, medication. Yes, but His children, is the people, they misuse. They use in wrong ways, that's why. He creates all the things, plants, herbs, fruits, vegetables, creates the best for his children. Don't misuse those things he creates. Don't misuse. Don't use it the wrong way. He has created the things he has created. Thank you for listening. Believe in it and boldly mention. Don't feel shy. Don't feel awkward. Don't feel bad to mention his name on the YouTube, on the internet. Don't miss the chance. Boldly, because he is alive. He loves all his children. Thank you for listening. Pray for one another. Pray for me too. Thank you. May God bless you all. See you next time with new songs.